Hello, my name is Enoch, and I am a newbie game dev currently still in high school. Today I'll be sharing how I went from knowing nothing about Unity to having a complete and published game on the Google Play Store in just 3 months. The game is now published and free to download from the Google Play Store. If you're interested, the link will be in the description below. Here's how I made it. This isn't my first experience with game dev. I've been making games with Scratch since I was in 4th grade, and I've made some cool stuff with Scratch too. My game dev fundamentals were developed during that time. I learned how to polish games, how to balance the game mechanics, and of course, also developed my base of programming logic. I was definitely comfortable with a simple yet powerful Scratch editor, and sharing my work with the familiar community was easy and encouraging. But one major reason people don't take Scratch seriously as a game engine is the fact that there is no other way to share your projects other than sharing it on the official Scratch website. There's no way your game could be exported and shared to another platform. So that's the one thing that pushed me out of my comfort zone and into this whole new sea of knowledge. I had always known that my next step was going to be Unity. It seemed like the most popular one, and it had a lot of devoted developers producing Unity-related resources that I could learn from. Even though the path seemed clear, I was still uncertain that I could make it past these stages. You see, I have attempted to start learning Unity multiple times, and with every attempt, I would encounter some issue that was way beyond my skill level. With the tutorial failing to tell me what to do to fix the problem, I would try everything I could to find a solution, but in the end I would still get stuck. What was different this time? First, I learned to ask Google whenever I bumped into a problem, and second, I worked with a regular working schedule. Having Google tell me what to do next when the tutorial failed was a big improvement. Big thanks to all the people who shared their knowledge to answer questions on Unity forms. You guys are lifesavers. The next thing that I have changed with this attempt is the routine. In previous attempts, I would work on my project in sprints, which meant I would work when I felt like it and stopped when I'm satisfied. Working in sprints was a habit that I carried from Scratch, where I could usually finish the entire project in a weekend, so sprinting would be a suitable pace of working. But when learning to use a new tool, sprinting is not the best idea. I would often find myself hitting obstacles, then trying very hard to solve these issues before I ended the sprint. This often leads to wearing out all of my patience and giving up. The better method to learning a new tool is to apply a marathon pace. This may seem to reduce the amount of work I'm doing in a single sitting, but in the long run, I'm actually starting fresh every day, and I will have more commitment if I'm working on it on a regular basis. For me, I wake up at 6 in the morning and start working on my game. This makes me want to wake up early since it means getting more time to work on my game, and working on the game is a really good way to start a day. I'll only work 1 hour every morning, as I'll have to stop because of school. Arranging the time so that school will force me to stop working is a really good way to ensure that I won't end up sprinting and overworking myself. So, with these two new habits, I was able to make good progress as I followed Unity tutorials for the first few weeks. After a month or so, I decided to try to make my own game. First, I followed a tutorial to get the fundamentals of the game. I followed a Flappy Bird tutorial and finished it within 1 day. Next, I started working on making the game my own. The idea of this game isn't new, it's actually a remake of an old game I made on Scratch, but the original Scratch version is weird and broken, so I want to use this chance to try and fix it. For the next month, I kept on adding different features like bullets or tanks. Day by day, I built up more and more of my game. I even kept a devlog on my Facebook page to motivate myself. On the way, I've met many obstacles, but because I have a scheduled routine to stick to, the damage isn't as severe. My commitment to keep working on this game was the main reason I was able to finish this project. The online version of the game was published on itch.io as a free browser game. It was a big milestone for me. It was the first official game I have ever published anywhere outside of Scratch. The next stage is, of course, publishing it to the Google Play Store. This took me another month to get right, and was definitely as challenging, if not more challenging, than making the game itself. My game was rejected repeatedly, and with every rejection email came a handful of new issues that I had to solve in order to resubmit. And another reason why this process is painful is the time it takes for Google to carefully inspect your game. I appreciate the effort Google is putting to keep their community safe and positive, but the feeling when you are waiting for your game to be inspected and possibly rejected for the fourth time in a row is just too much. You want to help make the process faster and smoother, but there's just nothing you can do. Imagine doing this for a month, receiving the rejection email, looking online for solutions, making changes to the game, resubmitting the game, and waiting for a few days and hoping the changes made have solved the issues, then getting another rejection email, then repeating all this again. When I received the email from Google Developer Support on Tuesday morning, I was expecting another rejection. There's probably something wrong with the metadata again, I thought, as I tapped the email open. On the email, in bold green text, was the message, "Published." My game was finally approved and had been published on the Google Play Store. This was a great surprise. Finally, after all that hard work and commitment, my work can be shared with others and downloaded directly from the Google Play Store. That was the adventure I went through, from knowing nothing about Unity to having a complete and published game on the Google Play Store in just 3 months. My two habits to guide me on the way were Google and the regular working schedule. One gave me guidance when no one else could, and the other reminded me to work at a steady and consistent pace. So, if you're thinking about learning Unity from scratch, or you're still nervously waiting for an acceptance letter from Google, I hope sharing my experience will help you, or at the very least, give you a good laugh. That will be it for this video. I hope you like my content. If you want to support me, please hit the like and subscribe button. If you have any advice on how I could improve my game, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching my video, and I'll see you next time.